Welcome to Producer Profile. I'm Stella Winston.
And I'm Jim Hill.
Our guest producer is born in Cumberland Hospital, right here in Brooklyn. He's raised in Fort Greene and living in Bed-Stuy. He is rooted in this part of Brooklyn. And his name is China, better known in the neighborhood as Tony the Barber. I'd like to welcome you to Producer Profile.
How you doing today?
Okay, good.
Let me ask you right from the start. What made you want to give back? You have a wonderful program, and we want to hear about it, but what made you want to give back to the community?
Well, that's probably be answered in two parts. One, I received a lot from the community. You know, I didn't just run through the community. I was raised within that community, and when I came up, there was so much for me to do there. You had Dr. White with the German Bugle Corps. You had Solomon with the cadets. You had the after-school programs. It was so much for me to do within the community. And as I got older, I seen it basically diminish. Or not really diminish, but it did increase. And the need for the children in the neighborhood has increased. They need more. They don't need knock hockey games and check games. They need high-tech stuff. They play with video games. They need something that's going to excite their mind just as much as a video game would, not hockey and night basketball all the
time.
So
you had mentioned in a previous conversation, like, they need to learn how to make the animated characters.
Exactly.
They need to learn how to use the technology that they're playing with.
Right, because it's not that difficult. They can actually learn. They can be taught. I mean, if you can be taught, you know, ABCs, you can be taught the other things, too. Putting a computer together for an example. If anybody ever looked inside of one, right, you can't mess it up. You can't, like, stick the sound card in the wrong spot. You can't stick the video card in the wrong spot. It's like a little child sticking a square peg in a square hole and a round peg in a round hole. It's just escalated a little bit. You know, they fit in each other's slots. So that, with a little small knowledge about voltage, they could put it together. They could actually have a finished product of their own.
Now, you have a business. You are a barber. You have a barber shop. And you even give back in your barber shop, from what I understand. Like, you give comic books when they get an A on a test.
Yeah.
You know, how does your barber shop work in giving back to the community?
Well, my barber shop, the barber shop that I work in, right, Fred Coleman's owns the shop.
Okay.
I work there. And it's basically a base that I can see street level what's going on in the neighborhood. You know, it's community. I'm right there with you. It's not like I'm somebody that's talking down to you. You see me every day. You know, you know, if you walk past the store, if you needed a quarter, you see me in the store. So it's not like I'm a stranger to them or somebody like a teacher or somebody above them where it's like, you know, talking down to them. I'm talking to you eye to eye, which is the same language that you use. So, you know, they understand a little bit more. And when you get their understanding, you get their insight, you get to push them a little bit more. You know, say, well, look, I know you bad, but if you do this today, you're gonna be good. Mm-hmm. And if they just do it today, you know, they can carry that on. But today I'm good. I'm gonna be good tomorrow too. They don't have to be, you know, what they was or what somebody quote unquote made them or want them to be.
Now, go ahead.
China, something happened yesterday. I was looking at Black Forum. And they really went down on the barbershop, you know, like it is. They was talking about that movie and stuff like that. Just for a second, did that bother you?
Well, the movie The Barbershop was a good movie. It was funny. But if it portrayed a barbershop in a traditional sense, maybe the small community shop, two or three chairs. But when you have a barbershop, say like the one I work in, you have 12 barbers, 4 beauticians and a loctician. These people feed kids, they pay rent and mortgage out of there. It's a business. It's a formal business. And it's one of the last few formal businesses within a black, in the neighborhood that's still a black institution. I mean, the church, and then you have the barbershop. Everything else is, you know, migrates, you know, mm-hmm. to the Eastern Europeans, to the Spanish and Dominicans, mm-hmm. got the stores, the Arabs, they got stores, the Koreans got the restaurants. But, you know, you're not going to a Korean barbershop to get your hair cut. You know,
right.
You're not going to let an Arab, you know, do your nails, say, or something like mm-hmm. that. You know, so the barbershop is one of the few black institutions that's left in the neighborhood. Now, I watched Black Forum myself, and I think what they just did was they just missed the point.
Okay.
And what was the point?
The point is that, you know, being a barber is a profession that has to be respected. And if you don't really want to respect my profession, you just need to just, you know, step around me. You know what I mean? Because I have a direction. I'm going somewhere. I got, you know, like my youngest child is a high school senior. I'm looking to pay college tuition next year. I don't need the negativity. I need the positive. And if the more positive I surround myself with, the better things is going to be. You know, negative is always going to be there. I can't stop that.
Well,
I can just avoid it.
You're a very positive person. You have a organization called Joy for Kids Incorporated.
Yes.
That you have co-created or created.
Created that.
You created
for
it?
For the first 3 years, it was basically a one-man band.
Really? Oh, yeah.
Jamil knows it was a one-man band, knocking on every door, every store, every restaurant, everybody. Anybody had a toy or a piece of food stuff that they wanted to donate, I needed it. You know what I mean? And that's basically how it started. It just, you know, and over the years, certainly in the last 6 months, I acquired two staff members. Joseph Mackey is my associate director, and Tracy Richardson is the program director. And our focus on what we do with the kids and the enrichment of the kids is basically all we really need to do. That's all we do.
Okay, we're going to talk more about your organization in a moment. We're going to take a musical break. We're going to hear James Brown perform Mother Popcorn
all
with the JDs. Okay.
Oh, Lord.
Me.
Welcome back to Producer Profile. Our guest is China, and he has an organization called Joy for Kids Incorporated, and we were talking about that before the musical break and how it started. It started about 4 years ago. And
Actually, 5 years
ago. 5 years ago.
Right.
And it's grown, and you, in this last event, you gave, what, a 1,000 toys?
Generally it's 1,000. This year was the first year we dipped under 1,000 because of the venue. Normally, every first 4 years we've done it at the Brooklyn Marriott.
Mm-hmm.
This year, at the last minute, they wanted a $5,000 fee, and it just was not feasible financially to give them that much money and still run the show. So we did it at the Christian Life Center on Myrtle Avenue, and we broke it up into two shows, an early show and a late show, so we can accommodate most mm-hmm. of the kids. But we still got in 850 kids, 860
kids. That's amazing that you are able to do that.
Well, the kids are there.
Yeah.
Their desires are there. You just have to manifest something to so they can, come. It's not like they're hiding. I mean, they're there. You know what mm-hmm. I mean? You give them something interested, and they'll be interested. I use the Christmas show as maybe a platform to speak to them. I might be speaking more to the parents at times than the children, but as long as somebody's hearing it, it's going to be heard. Mr. Hill gave me many speeches in my youth, man, that, if he spoke to me 10 times and all I got was 10% of what he said 10 times, I got a 100% of a message eventually.
Okay, just for the viewing audience, Mr. Hill was your teacher at one
teacher,
time?
Teacher, dean. Person that chased me out the hallways, when I was bad.
Kept you in line,
yeah, And then he didn't leave me. As I grew up, he was still in the neighborhood.
He was still in the neighborhood.
You know what I mean? And that's things like that make me want to give back to my neighborhood, to mm-hmm. see how Mr. Hill gave back and the difference that it made just simply me. So I know if I can make a difference in one person, I done something, outside of
my own
children.
What is your view of people who, leave for greener pastures, so-called greener?
Well, I don't really have a bad view of them. You know what I mean? It's just, because a lot of them, they leave and they go away and they like, oh, look, I did mine, Mm-hmm. That's personal. I don't want to get into the personality
right.
differences mm-hmm. of people, because people are going to be people, It's just, I concentrate, like I said, on the positiveness of certain people, because you can find negativity everywhere.
Everywhere.
But it's the good person.
So if money was no object and you could do what you really want to do in your heart of hearts for your community, what would you do?
I'll probably set up some kind of foundation where the kids can explore all their possibilities. Introduce them to science. Introduce them to, say, astronomy. Introduce them to levels of electronics, like not just like electronic, but the electronic that flow between transistor to transistor. That's another form of electronics. And I would try to capture their desires earlier. Mm-hmm. I don't want to do it in high school. I want to do it earlier. When I was coming up, they had those 50-in-1 electronic sets my grandmother used to buy me. I was young, and I was making radios and little clocks. You can do it, but you just have to put it out there for the kids. If it's not there, they won't utilize it. What they utilize is what they see. That's the guy standing in front of the building when they go to the store.
So you're an educator.
Oh, that's a big title. That's a big shoe for me to put on,
Well,
I'm a barber and a sound man and somebody that loves
future
children.
Educator.
All right.
That's okay. All right. You're allowed to dream. We're going to take a look at the B-roll, the clip of the last event, and this was the Christmas event.
Right.
Can you set it up for us?
The Children's Christmas Celebration, and this was at the Christian Life Center on Myrtle Avenue this year.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not quite sure if it's the first or the second show,
mm-hmm.
but it was a nice event. We had a nice magician there, and we gave out nice toys and a little more snack and food stuff for them. And we let them run around a little bit. You let them stretch their legs, Then you sit them down and you give them something that's exciting.
Okay, so let's take a look at it.
It was the first show.
First show. Can I look?
Okay.
Alright, we're gonna give a few thanks here, right? First, you're gonna have to thank the Christian Life Center for allowing us to use the sanctuary for the show. Because the Marriott worth money, alright? Next year, me, my man Dave, we're gonna work that out where we're gonna be in there. Because I like 1,000 kids in front of me, that's what I like to see. That's Pastor Jackson. You know, if y'all feel free, y'all can come to church on Sunday. I want to thank Chase, because Chase donated some of the funds that purchased some of the things that's here, helped pay for these guys. So if you need a bank, go save your money. Matter of fact, I should save your money anyway. You should get a little kid saving thing going on. You can put like $1 a month away. You'd be surprised how much that add up after about 15 years, especially with senior dues is about ready. So your parents, y'all should know. I got two seniors, the dues is due. Trust me. I thank Transit Workers for Children. All right, now that organization's been with this event from day one. Day one, you gotta thank them. You need transit workers, you know, if you're not with them, you need to join them, because they do a lot of things within Brooklyn, Manhattan, Bronx. They move around, they're a lot more vast than I am. They just give me a helping hand, push me on my way. We got Toys R Us, Mr. Richard Brown from Toys R Us. He gave us some toys last year, gave us some toys this year, right? And I want to thank people like Miss Berry that works in the community. You got Mr. Hill that's constantly, you know, when I was a kid, he was working in this community. You know what I mean? And he didn't took vows beyond vows that most of us wouldn't take to dedicate himself and his life to this community. You know? And without further ado, you know, I'm stop talking. I'm gonna let my man smoke your guns. Trust me, I seen them. They nothing to play with. Give me your attention. We're gonna get these. All right, now, y'all gonna see some things that these guys are gonna do. Do not go home and do it. You know what I mean? Do not play with fire. Do not play with smoke. Do not play with nothing bad, and that's all bad. Smoke, fire, guns. You know, don't do it at home. And knives, they got some knives. So don't play with no knives. Just see it and just absorb it, and then don't do it.
We have two rules. If you like magic, clap your hands. And if you don't like it, still clap your hands. All right, just give me one second.
Just saying how important an event like that can be in a child's life, because what happens is that they come to look forward to those type of events. It becomes a marker in their childhood. So what you're doing is very significant for a lot of children. They're going to look back on their childhood with fond memories, thanks to you.
I hope one of them pick up the show and continue it on. You
okay.
Because I'll be old soon.
Well, you see, that's what it's all about. But do you love the work part of it? The struggle?
It's a challenge. I love the challenge of it.
Okay.
You know, I like it when I call somebody up and they tell me, well, look, no, I can't give you no toys this year, you know. Well, maybe you shouldn't do the show this year. That just makes me say, like, all right, look, let me get the next number. It's the challenge. It's the constant challenge, you know. maybe it was something that instilled in me when I was younger, you know, always wanted to beat the challenge, or you can't pass that test. Oh, look, I'm going to go home and study them. I'm going to ace that test. Mm-hmm. You can't be a sound tech engineer. Who's going to teach you about phase and speakers and electronics, you know? You know, I passed that challenge, you know? It's just a matter of overcoming the small challenges. Each small obstacle brings you further to the top. Every step you walk up brings you further to the top of the stairs.
Now, you also are involved with bringing the circus to town. Which circus is that?
That's the Soul Circus, mm-hmm. right? I was instrumental in the very first year in getting them to New York, period. Because I seen them out of state. I seen them in Atlanta. I seen them in Virginia. And I wanted to bring them here. But at the time, my finances just wasn't. It just wasn't correct. It just wasn't nowhere near that kind of finance and that kind of event. It was like, I'd do promotions, and when I had contacted the people, the numbers were so large, you know, they like, you know, Cheerios and Ford actually sponsored that, brings them here. So that's not something that, you know, you just shake a few dollars at. You know, you really need a lot of sponsorship. Don't think of the black circus as just some circus from around the corner. Again, that's an institution that's growing, mm-hmm. and they're growing nationally, and they're growing. And even in their show is growing. So, yes, I helped that. And mm-hmm. this year, now, every year we still rent the tent out one whole night. We get the tent and we get all our kids in there. And, you know, that's what we use it for, an award. We give, you know, each other the awards and, you know, give the kids a show again.
Good.
Let me ask you something. Your main goal right now for the new year, what is that?
For Joy for Kids?
Yeah.
It's actually to reach more kids,
okay.
to generate a platform that I can attack more kids.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I say attack because they're being attacked in other ways. So
right.
I want to attack them too. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? I want to bombard them with things beyond their reach so they can reach for it.
Right.
So they can stop looking behind them, looking over their shoulder. They can look forward and actually go in that direction.
Now, Tony, you know that there's a lot of negativity in our community. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, I'll never forget going into the barbershop one day and all those youth were shot. You know, that was so painful that I couldn't get my hair cut.
What
you
happened?
Know, just before, you know, we're going on. I mean, there was nothing but police cars and then I don't know what, maybe four or five
guys got shot throughout right. the neighborhood right there in a little area.
Right in the area where you go to the barbershop.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you see all this. I know you hear all this.
Every day.
I mean, and a lot of these, some of my students have passed through this existence like this.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and sometimes when I go into the barbershop, you know, some of my students talk about, you know, how they used to hold up banks
mm-hmm.
and stuff like that. What does this do to you? I mean, does it bother you?
It deflates my spirit to a point, but it helps drive you, you know, greater to your goal, you know,
okay.
that I need to stop them, you know, while they're young. You
right.
got to let the children know that the person next door is not your enemy. The guy in the next building is not somebody that you need to go against. That's your neighbor. This is your community. There's got to be some community camaraderie there so we can understand and grow as a community. It took, like I said, it took Mr. Hill. It took Mr. Cox. It took Solomon. You know, it took other people to raise me. I just wasn't raised by my grandmother. It took the community to raise me. And I want the community to raise the kids within the community now. And we don't have to go, like, I'll give you an example. Like, you can fight somebody in your next building outside on the street. It'd be your enemy. If y'all get locked up in jail in Brooklyn, or we both from Fort Greene, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Now we buddies.
Right.
It's a division there that we have to break down. You have to stop dividing yourself up. You my friend now, you're gonna be my friend in 10 years. You know, if you're gonna be a basketball player and I'm gonna be a bum, we can still be friends. You know what I mean? Just because I'm not upwardly mobile, that doesn't mean I can't be your friend. I can't help you in certain ways.
Well, that's an important message that I hope you get across in the new year and in the years to come. I want to thank you for coming to Producer Profile.
And I want to thank y'all for having me. It's a mm-hmm. great pleasure being mm-hmm. here.
And good luck with your organization. I'm Stella Winston.
And I'm Jim Hill.
Okay, you've been watching Producer Profile. Excellent.
Thank you.
Okay.